I'm Dave Miersch. I am the Workday Adaptive Planning Practice Leader here at Revelwood. Today we're going to be walking through how to utilize active planning dashboards within Adaptive and to consolidate a data entry for budgeting purposes combined with reporting mechanisms using dashboards.
Okay, so I have open on my screen currently, I have a dashboard that's been pre-built, and certainly we'll spend a few seconds here walking through how to build a very simple one of these. However, as you can see, we have some standard dashboard metrics, charts, and views, but also in the middle of the screen here, we also have a product revenue sheet. It is a cube sheet that we've displayed on this dashboard. And as you can see, I am at a lower level here at the sales north for my working forecast. And I have data entry points that are available from this sheet. Now, the great thing about this is that this sheet is the exact replica and tied to the actual product revenue sheet that exists in my sheets within Adaptive Planning. Same functionality, same views, same filters. And right now, what we're going to do is just to show you how we can use this for easy planning and reporting so we don't have to jump back and forth across multiple screens. Is I'm going to look at my units row right here for product A1, for customer one, and for sales north level. And I'm just going to make a big change just so the numbers are actually viewable. Now, this is probably not going to be reality in your case, but just to show you the movement of the dashboards along with the sheet entry itself. I'm going to enter my units for August of 2021 in this case, which is currently 184 units. I'm going to convert that up to 5,000 units. It was a very strong month for us. We're going to save that just like we would a normal entry. And once that renders in the sheet, you'll see all the dashboards in real time also update right away. We can see August of 2021 has jumped up dramatically compared to other months as well as compared to what it was. And similar to any other dashboard functionality, we can drill into that data by going into it by product, by customer, by brand, or exploring that data using Cell Explorer. I'm going to drill into it very quickly by product. You'll see here we'll jump down a little bit, and you'll notice all the product entries for all the different types of products in this demo instance. And we look at product A1, much larger revenue coming in for product A1 in August of 2021. That is because I made that data entry point of the units for 5,000 versus the 184 that was there previously. And it's also in customer one. All right. And now that we're back into our drill through, I'm going to hit back real quick. And that's pretty much all there is to it for our active dashboard planning. We can modify these targets. We can modify our entry points. In addition to this information, we also have the options up here on the right-hand side of the sheet dashboard, the sheet menu. There's three dots in a vertical line. If I click on those, I have the option of changing my display options, adding sheet notes, or like we have in any other cube sheet in Adaptive, I can change my dimensions. I can swap columns and rows. So if I hit change dimension, if I wanted to finish planning for customer one and product A1, I can switch from customer one to product A2. Hit okay. That sheet itself will refresh. The dashboards have not changed because I have not changed any data itself within the actual entry sheet. And I'll come back here as well. I'll go back and I'll do July in this case, and I'll change the 167 to 400. I'll enter that, hit save. And we'll watch our dashboards update in real time. And now we have our different entry points. So a slightly smaller increase in July because I didn't do as exaggerated of an input in that case for that period. So now I want to quickly show you how to add these dashboards into add these sheets into a dashboard. I'm going to hit edit and open up a new blank dashboard. I'm going to call this test for the time being. And on the left-hand side, with any new dashboard in any edit mode, we have all our options to add charts, views, graphs, etc. I'm just going to go down to the second from last one here, which is a sheet. I'm going to click on that. You'll see a blank option shows up. I can change my name. I'll save that for when I actually decide what sheet I want to load. In this case, I'll go to my data settings, I will select the sheet. In this case, I'm going to select my my workforce planning module. I'll scroll down to workforce planning. That will instantly pop up as my new sheet. I'm going to go back to my sheet name and just call it workforce planning. And here I can then modify the visual cues from this as far as expanding or collapsing the actual size. And once I hit done, this sheet is now available for entry. I can change these inputs, change start dates. I can change salary amounts, just like I would with any other workforce planning sheet within Adaptive. And that's all there is to it. At this point, I would just add in my additional charts, views, and reports within the dashboard, and I would call it a day and give my budget contributors the keys to the castle, and they can go on their merry way of budgeting and forecasting.
Thank you for watching. If you have any additional questions, please reach out to us at info@revelwood.com.